So hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. I hope you guys are doing great. So in this video I'm going to show you how you can create this clock animation in the Blender with the help of the drivers. So without any further delay, now let's get started tutorial. So first of all guys, I just want to show you the animation. So here you can see right now that clock is moving very nicely, and if I will increase the keyframe, so here you can see that R key and that minute hand is also moving very nicely. So how I did this, so first of all I just want to show you some variable which is I'm going to use in this video, so you will get better idea what we are going to do. So these are some variable which is I have used in this video. So here you can see this is the second variable, minute variable and hour variable also. So in the right side here you can see I did those variable to very easy to use. So here you can see, so now I'm just going to show you how you can use this basically. So right now I'm just going to show you some example. First of all, so here you can see that second key is moving continuously. So if you want to move this key like a tick 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 tick, so how you can do this? So for that you have to just click on this second key, then you have to just press the N on your keyboard. From here you can see I put the driver on the Y rotation, so I will just do right click and then I will do edit driver. So here you can see here is these variable which is I have shown you. Okay, so first of all what I'm going to do, I'm just going to change this floor and then I will just start bracket, open bracket, and then I will just put close bracket. So here you can see now that key is moving like a classical animation. Here you can see which is normal clock is doing. So that's how you can change the animation speed and values also. Okay, so now let's start the animation and how we can do exactly. And before starting the video guys, if you want to do practice on this project file, so you can download this project file from the description, that will be free for my all subscriber. And if you found this video and this project file helpful for you, so make sure you hit the like button, hit the share button and subscribe my channel also guys. So now let's start a tutorial. So I'm just going to open a fresh file. Okay, so let's do it. So here you can see guys, our brand new file is open, and now I'm just going to show you how you can do this animation and how you can use the drivers basically. So first of all I'm just going to do my front view, and here I'm just going to add one empty pressing the shift A, and I'm just going to use the plane axis empty, and now I'm just going to move it little bit beside on the left side basically. Okay, so first of all I'm just going to change this name as a time, yeah, something like that. So after that I will add the driver on this empty. So how we can add the driver basically, I'm just going to press the N on my keyboard, and here you can see we are on the item section, and this is the transformation of this empty. So we're going to add the driver on this Z location. Okay, and if you don't know how to add the driver, so you have to just hover your mouse whatever axis you want to give the driver, and then you have to just do the right click, and from here you will see the add driver. You have to just click the add driver, and when you click on the add driver, that color will turn violet, and that's mean our driver is active. Okay, so what I'm going to do basically, I'm just going to do this empty Z location link with the our timeline speed, timeline playback speed. Okay, so how we can link this? So we'll use the driver for it. So first of all I'm just going to split my window something like that, and then I'm just going to open my driver window from here, and here you can see this is the Z location which is we have added driver. Okay, I'm just going to click on it, and then I will just press the N, and from here I will select the driver. So these are some driver properties where we are going to do work. So this is the type basically, there are lots of script types, but we are going to use only scripted expression, and this is the expression section. And here you can see right now we can see one expression here, it's a var plus 00, var means variable basically, this is the short form of the variable. And right now here you can see one error here, it's called invalid Python expression. So what is exactly? So it's showing because we didn't save our file yet. So first of all we have to save our file, so I'm just going to save my file clock animation, yeah, something like that. But here you can see after saving this file, it is still that error is showing. So the reason behind it, because we have to put some valid expression here, then it will not show. Okay, and we have to do some other setting also. So after that it will gone. So first of all, I'm just going to link this Z location with the this timeline speed. So for the timeline, we have only one expression, it's called frame. Yeah, and here you can see when I wrote the frame, that empty is gonna little bit upside. And after that, we have to just select this object, that time. Yeah, that's it. And now we have to just change the type as a Z location. Okay, so here you can see now if I will move my timeline slider, so that empty will be going to move according to our timeline. Okay, so our first driver and first step is done. So now I'm just going to add the driver on my that red second key, basically second hand. So for that we will do same thing. So I'm just going to hover my mouse on the y-axis and do right click and do add driver. And here you can see this is the y-axis driver. So right now I'm just going to add here that expression which is I have shown in starting of my video. Okay, so which is basically the var multiplied to pi divided by 30. Okay, then we have to just select that time empty, and we have to just change the location to the Z location. So here you can see when I will press the tab, so our second key is moving very nicely, but right now that key is moving according to the per frame, not a per second. So if you want to make this key rotation as a per second, so for that you have to just change some variable from this empty, time empty. So you have to just change this expression, just divided by 30. And now here you can see second key will be moved now per second. Okay, so our first our second animation is also done, our second key and second hand animation is also done. So now I'm just going to select this key, and then I'm just going to do right click, and here I will just do copy driver. Then I will select my minute key. Okay, so now I'm just going to hover my mouse on the top of the y-axis, and then I will do paste driver. Right now I will just change only one expression here, then I will just change the 1800, and that's it. So here you can see if I will play this, if I will move this slider to the 1800, so our 1 minute is complete. Here you can see. Okay, so that is also working very nicely. Then I will do same thing with the that R key. I'm just going to the hover my mouse on top of this y-axis, then I will do paste driver. And right now I will just change only one expression also, 21600, and I will do enter. And now here you can see, if I will show you here, so our R key is also moving very nicely. Okay, and now you can just set your time, and you can take a render. So after that you will get the time animation, that clock animation basically. So that's how you can use the driver creating for the clock animation. And don't forget to download this project file. Okay, if you want to do practice on this project file, so you can download this project file from the description, that will be free for my all subscriber. Okay, so thanks for watching this video guys. If you learned something in this video, please hit the like button, hit the share button, and subscribe my channel. Also, if you have any queries, if you have any suggestion, please let me know in the comment box. I will definitely reply comment. So bye bye, take care, and stay home guys.